Good evening, Celonauts fans, and welcome back to Munich, Germany. We're here wrapping up day one of our 2 days of live coverage of Celosphere here on theCUBE. My name's Savannah Peterson, bringing you all the best from Bavaria with Rob Strechay. Rob, it's been an emotional day, it's been an exciting day, it's been an educational day. Where do we start?
I think we start with the fact that, you know, some of their major themes are the ROI of AI.
Right.
And one of the things that I found very fascinating is that they also talked about you can't do AI without PI or process intelligence. Those two big themes have driven a lot of the discussions I think we've had. What about yourself?
One thing that I think has been really beautiful about this is in the AI era, we talk about minimizing human impact on certain things, but I feel like there's been a real focus on the human loop from everything from Nobel Peace Prize winners on the main stage today in the keynote to really optimizing the work experience for folks who are leveraging process intelligence so that they can get that ROAI, as everyone's talking about here. It's been really refreshing. You know, when we think about business processes, the first thing that you think of isn't always warm, fuzzy feelings, right? You think about data and details and the little tiny nodes that build any business. But what I love about working with Celonauts is they always bring us these really interesting customer and partner stories. The focus has truly been on liberating some of this data, getting data out of data jail like we were talking about with Dan Brown earlier. I love that notion, and it's truly about empowering people to do their best work and have the most fun at work while they're at it.
Yeah, and I think just bridging off of Dan, I think, you know, we've gotten to see behind the scenes of a lot. I mean, there's a lot more announcements. We have a full day tomorrow, but
yes, we do.
A lot of the integrations that they're doing with people like Databricks at the Delta sharing layer and doing other things that are very interesting with Microsoft and some other partners that are out there. I think there's, we're going to talk to a lot of them tomorrow as well. I think when we talk to Dan and understanding that he looks at this and they've done a lot of the hard work underneath the hood to make this there. We haven't even gotten in, it's been brought up once today, but MCP,
yeah,
and MCP server for making, you know, linking up with agentic AI.
I was thinking about that
AI
as well. Yeah.
I'm sure we're going to talk about it at length tomorrow, but I look at it and I say that, it, to your point, and I think that I love this too, is there's been a humanity to AI. And I think—
Absolutely.
We, you know, I've said it a couple times today, AI's that wave at our back. And one of the things that it's doing is if it can crash on you if your processes aren't right. If you're building agents that—
Great analogy, Rob, I love it.
It. So, but I mean, other things that you saw maybe.
Well, one thing that really stuck out to me, we got a really nice press briefing yesterday, and I appreciated that they have 11 champions, as they call them, champion Celonauts, if you will. They've actually realized, not hypothetical, you know, we talk about making AI real, right? They've achieved $1 billion in value.
Yeah.
And I think that's nothing to scoff at. I can't think of too many instances where, you know, you and I are on the news desk talking about AI literally every day, and I haven't heard of that level of tangible, scalable result in a lot of circumstances.
Yeah, in fact, they talked about it even at a higher level with 120 of these Celonaut champions. Not the there's 11 with these green, they had their Celonauts jackets on, and they stood up and got a good cheer today. But then there's, beyond that, there's another 109, I think I did the math right, it's out of 120, it's getting late. So, you know, and there's some good music
going now.
The math
isn't mathing?
Yes, it's math isn't mathing. So, wait, so the math, I'm trying to make it math, and when you look at the 120, it was 8.1 billion.
Wow.
Which is like just incredible. And I think what a lot of the people who were on today, we had Monica on talking about where they were from last year to this year, with helping people within the criminal justice system and how that comes together and help them, and her and Erin, and what the important work they're doing to expose the processes to keep people from repeat offending. I think, again, it's those human stories coming in, and, you know, again, with Louise and former CIO of Metro Bank talking about how she loves just getting that out, but how she taught, and I thought she did a really good job of saying, this is how I rank order my processes. I mean, that's a must watch for any CIO
Totally. That was a masterclass.
It was.
You know who else I really enjoyed having on the news desk back again? It is really nice to have repeat guests from last year into this year. I loved having Peter Budweiser on.
Yeah.
Because I feel like, you know, you and I, again, we're doing this every day. No one wants to talk about geopolitics and tariffs in most circumstances, despite it being an enormous elephant in the room anytime we're having a conversation in HPC, AI, really anything, honestly, at this stage. But I love that they've created a solution for their customers to help navigate that and to be able to both forecast as well as be prepared when the unexpected happens, which is kind of the challenge of most businesses in 2025.
Yeah, I think again, and then, you know, ending the day with Carsten and the conductor, it was like really just fascinating how it brings it together and how many different applications between tech, business, and something that's completely unattached. And Carsten, I think, you know, he's always really laying it out in a very good way about the importance of freeing the process. And I think that was really key.
One thing I think that's consistent, I'm glad you brought that up, is you know, both Carsten and Alex, and really everyone we have on the news desk here, they are very clear in how they speak about things, and Celonis provides clarity for all of their customers. Yeah. So, you know, it's pretty on brand for them, I guess.
I agree, totally agree.
Well, Rob, I am really looking forward to day two. I believe we have 16 segments tomorrow, which is going to be juicy. Be sure and get some rest tonight.
Yeah, definitely early to bed.
Early to bed. That'll be that's a part of our business process for today.
That is our business process for today. So.
I hope that wherever you all are, you get sweet dreams and that you're prepared for our thrilling 16 segments here at day two of Celosphere tomorrow. My name is Savannah Peterson. You're watching theCUBE, the leading source for enterprise tech news.